You Star Wars fans, Fly Guy here for FlyGuy.net, giving you another look at a Black Series figure, one which I hadn't got round to reviewing yet, which is Marajade. Let's give you a zoom in on the card. This is my opener, so the card's a bit bashed. I've got one minty fresh one, which I picked up from DarkSideToys.com, but I was chucking this one around here. As I said, I opened this one up. So there you go. One thing to note, number 14 in the series, it says Marajade on the front. And the minimal packaging we get, obviously, as we're used to the Black Series. But on the back of it, you'll note there at the bottom, Marajade Skywalker. So a little bit of, don't know quite what Hasbro were trying to tell us there, whether this is one figure, two figures, different UPC, I don't know, but you get the idea. So there's a really nice shot on the back from, I don't know where that's from actually, somebody let me know, that'd be really good. Is that a comic shot, or what's that from? It looks very cool anyway, with a very good looking Marajade. There's the story, well, a little bit of a brief synopsis of Marajade, and of course it does Stancy eventually marries Luke Skywalker, so that's the packaging. Oh boy, as you've probably seen many times, it took me a little while to get this one. I was happy enough to wait for it to arrive, but yeah, this figure is not the best. It's really all down to this head sculpt here, which is, as you can clearly see, nothing like the prototype that we were pretty much promised. So, really not the best overall, but we'll come back to the head sculpt in a minute, and let's look at the body itself, which is fantastic. It's rather cool. The skin tone looks good. The body shape looks good. There's a cool belt on her, utility belt, very Han Solo-like belt. She's got an unlit saber there, plugged into one hole on the front of the belt. The gun holster at the side there actually pops off quite easily, but it does plug in there. That's the holster she's got for that. A little bit of silver on the belt. And on the back, there's a fair bit of silver there as well. You'll see the details there on the kind of shin guards. That silver and that leather she's got there, a bit of Mara's bottom, and a hole on the utility belt at the back. And you can see some other bits and pieces. And if I pop her head off, which makes it a whole better figure, you'll see she's also got some kind of armor on the back there, that piece or ammo belt, whatever you guess you would call it, that goes round across her chest. So it's a very, very cool figure. The blade is purple, as you can see there, which I think it was supposed to be blue or red. I'm not quite sure, but I've seen it with purple blades before, but it's all one piece. Still a good lightsaber, but yeah, not the best. There is her blaster. Let me get a little better look at that blaster. You can just see the detail on that. So quite a cool and unique-ish blaster. I don't recall seeing that one before. Let me pop that out of hands. I'll show that a little better if we can. It's so incredibly small, very hard to see. There we go. So there's a little bit of detail on there. It's quite unusual, quite different. She holds it pretty well, and it pops into the holster. If the gun is in the holster, just as I drop it there, it tends to fall out or fall off her belt a little bit. It's just a little bit loose on mine, so you might need a little bit of blue tack to pop that on. Now, the head sculpt of the neck, look at the size of that neck there. So it makes it very difficult if you do want to do one of the head swaps, which I'm sure some of you heard about before. There's a couple of options out there. One is to swap them for a very cool figure with an excellent head sculpt. This is the Inferno Cannon Black Widow from the Avengers, which we reviewed in our TechSushi channel, youtube.com/TechSushi. A brilliant figure, it has to be said. Absolutely stunning. Nice little bottom there too. And the hair and the facial sculpts. All about the hair in this one, as we talked about in the review. Beautifully done. The facial sculpt looks on the money, and she looks slightly attractive. Sadly, on this one, we just get this kind of slightly ginger, like a dude dressed up there. Look at those eyebrows. I mean, what is going on with that hair? A little bit 80s Cobra going on. It's not so bad from the side. It's sculpted well and it's painted well, but it's like this gigantic, gingery, carroty eye. Look at those eyebrows. They're like caterpillars on her, man. That's crazy. Absolutely nuts. There has been some nice weathering done to the hair, but really, it's she must be, before she uses the Force in the morning, she's using a can of hairspray just to get that thing to set up. Nuts. Absolutely nuts. So, really, Hasbro, unfortunately, have dropped the ball on that facial sculpt, I think, as many would suggest. However, she is still selling like bloody hotcakes. So I'm not quite sure what you guys have all got for her, but out there you're buying her in droves. She is an excellent figure. I've seen some incredibly good customs already with those shin guards, actually painting them silver and grey and giving different colours, because the all-in-one black matte colour tends to be a little flat and dull. But it's very nice when we get these small touches, as you see on the belts, and particularly down on those buckles at the back of the shin guards. So it is a good figure, definitely one you want to have in the Black Series, but it is a bit of a disappointment on that head sculpt. Now, that Inferno Cannon Black Widow that we just talked about a minute ago, if I quickly show you her again, you can head swap that, but you will need a bit of a drill and you'll need to chop. And as you can see, the skin tone on each is really not the best. So you're going to have a bit of a miss and match. There is another one, the guys at yakface.com, an excellent article in their forums. I'll put a link underneath this if you want to see that other head sculpt. Unfortunately, that Black Widow is a little hard to acquire, so it's probably US only, and even then it's not online. It tends to be something just in US stores if you're lucky enough to find it. She is just, as far as I know, just Avengers Assemble Black Widow. She comes with a larger base, and I think is based off the Saturday morning cartoon series. So that's Black Widow. I'd love to hear your thoughts. Do you love her? Do you like her? What is it about Mara Jade that sends you guys absolutely nuts? Is she just a great character? Or I don't really get it. It's a good character, but not quite the frenzy that it seemed to be causing. So let us know. What do you also think about this facial sculpt? Is this thing horrendous? Or what? Leave a comment below. Love to hear your thoughts. And you can also join us for news and figure reviews, updates, and toy news and all sorts of stuff, as usual, on our social channels. The link underneath the video to all of them. If you've never subscribed before, hit the subscribe button. You will get lots of Star Wars video reviews straight into your inbox as soon as we get them. That's it. We'll see you for another Star Wars review coming up soon. Cheers.